All we need is a spark, a second chance, a lifeline.
Hello everybody, Mark Yaler here. Before we get into this today's video, I'd just like to say everything you're going to see in the video, they are three trail cameras from Ceyomur. They have been sent to me free of charge to review on my channel, and there will be links below to each one and where you can find them on Amazon and wherever at their best price. They seem on paper very, very good cameras. So I'm going to put them up in the woods here in front of me, and we are going to see what they capture, what sort of quality they capture, and are they really any good? Are they as good as the specifications that they say? So let's get into these cameras and...
All we need is a spark.
Here's the cameras that they've sent me. The CY55, the CY60, and the CY65. So the 55, 60, and 65. In the box, you basically get the same thing. You get the instruction book, you get the camera, you get the accessories. So you get a strap, a downloading cable, and the mounts. Okay, the mount there is a standard one that you get in all of the packaging there. The only difference, again, in the packaging was with the CY65, it came in a little box. Everything else just came in a little thing inside the box. Okay, so looking at it, then this one is the CY65. It's 1080, 30 megapixel picture, which, I mean, that's impressive, and a 10 photo burst. Again, that's pretty impressive. The thing that got me thinking about it is its Wi-Fi and Bluetooth support. It connects to your phone. It is a limited range, but it's not sort of like from here back to my house 15 miles away. It's not like that. Okay, so that's the camera. Okay, so moving down to the CY60. Okay, 1080 again, 24 this time, and 3 photo burst. Okay, one thing I've noticed in all of them, these instructions, they are very comprehensive and very, very good. And finally, the CY55, 20 megapixel, 1080, and a 3 photo burst. So they go from 20, 24, and 30 megapixel. Again, same sort of thing in the instruction book in multiple languages. Okay. All I can say is in the English part of it, it is the best I've come across yet. So let's have a look at the cameras. So we'll start off with the CY65. As you can see, it's quite a robust camera. I've used it a little bit in the garden just to see how it all works and that, and the connectivity of it. Yep, it is good. The connectivity, the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth works. It works much better in the field than actually in the house. It is difficult to get it to hook up in the house. I did find it easier to go through the app that you download. Brilliant. So I've got one clip on the side. There we are. Again, I'm doing all of this one-handed because I'm holding the camera here. You open it up and that's what you see. Okay, I've left the little protection thing on it here. Where is it? There it is. There's the thing for it. So let's start it up and see what we see. So to the middle section, there we are, see more, and then it asks you for a password. I password or protect all of my cameras. Thing is, people still come along and steal them. So what I'm going to do now is pause it, put the password in, and then move on. So there it is, turned on. Give you a close-up of the screen, try and get rid of that glare. I've taken off that protective thing because it seemed to have looked like in the camera, lots of little white bubbles in it. Anyway, so there we are. We've got the battery, we've got the date and time set. Let's go through some of this. So you press this thing at the top here and we go through to the menu. Come on, go to the menu. There we are. We go to the menu and there it is. So you can go to your photo and video, which I've set it to. Image size, I've set it to the maximum, and I've set it to the maximum for the video. So it's 30 megapixel and 1080 HD. Four photo burst. Okay, let's just go down now. Resolution, so if you want to change the resolution, press OK. So there we are, I'm going to the 1296, whatever that is. Hopefully that's all right. Back to the 1080. Oops. So OK, press the top button to move it up. OK to confirm and move on. Length of video, 20 seconds. If I go into that, you can actually manually set that to whatever thing you want. You can, I think you can set it up to about 3 or 4 minutes, or maybe even 5. Recording audio, yes. PIR interval, 30 seconds. Sensitivity medium, so on that one, let's take that to there. You've got high, low and medium, because I'm chasing deer here. Okay, I've managed deer on this farm. They're a big animal, so we only need it on medium. If you have it on high, from in the instructions, what it says is that it tends to then pick up all of the smaller things. So we don't want that. Time lapse, that's off. IR LED, which are black ones. So I say black in the sense that you don't actually see them fire, and it doesn't scare the animals. Low battery, so if they are running out, it won't use the IR, so that's a bit of a bummer. Monitoring period, don't use that. Side IR setup, we've got those on. English, yeah. Default settings, format, so let's format the memory card, and we'll talk about that in a moment. The memory card, it takes up to 128 megabytes, which is huge. I put 32 in there, so we'll see how that goes. Time and date, okay, you saw that was set. Format, 24-hour clock. Date set, stamp on. Beep sound I've turned off, because just like all of these, there are bloody annoying things. Beep, beep, beep all of the time. Camera name, password set in, Bluetooth on, Wi-Fi. Okay, Wi-Fi password. All that is explained in the instruction book, and it gives you the password. Okay, Wi-Fi turns off after a minute, auto power off after 3 minutes, backlight, and then the version, and then where manufacturers update, which you've got to plug in into your laptop, into their stuff, and blah blah blah, but everything's working fine. Okay, so we'll turn that back, and there we are again. So let's turn that off. Well, it was talking about the side IRs, that's these things here, or you can use the front one. These are the illuminators, and there's the camera and the detectors. So you've got side, front, and the detectors. Pretty cool. The battery, now this is nice. You push this button down here, and there it pops out. You've got a battery tray. Okay, I really like this tray idea. It works much better. Some of the others down here don't have a tray. You just open it up and pop them in. That's all right, but I do like this tray. So let's slide that back in. Obviously on there, the setup. And then you just click it to on, and it gives you a little countdown on here. And then you're away and you're recording stuff. So moving quickly on, we've got the CY60, the Ceyomur CY60, and here she is. As I said, very quickly, that one. You've got the same stuff as always. I only ever seem to use that. Most other people just seem to use that. So you've got, just like before, you've got two sides, IRs, detectors, got the front one, and then you've got your illuminator, and you've got your camera. Front one, and then you got your camera up here. Getting a bit carried away there. Right, so let's open this fella up, and there it is. Again, I didn't read the instructions on this, typical man, and it is very, very obvious how it all works. Off, test, and on. So we click it to test. See you more. Boom, boom, boom. And then it asks for your passcode again. So let's just stop this. I'll put that in.
All we need is a spark.
So there we are. There's my ugly mug on it. There's all your little illuminators. You've got your menu button. Let's put it down here and try and do it. So you've got your menu button. Let's press that one at the top. Menu up, down, OK, and mode. So let's press this one. Oh, just to go through on the screen. 24 megapixel. What pictures you've got. The date and the time and the temperature. It says 17. That's because it's been inside my truck. It's definitely not 17 degrees out here. Might have been last week, but definitely not now. So there we are, into the menu. Okay, and let's find that down arrow. There it is. So mode, photo resolution. Okay, and then it comes up with it. So I've set it to the maximum. So we click okay. Back to the down arrow, photo series. Okay. And you can take one photo, two photos, or three. I want three. I want to max everything out. Video resolution. Go on to that. Okay, 1920 by 1080. So it's on the full HD. I know some people say the 720 is HD, but 1080 is better. Surely it's got more numbers in it. It's a bigger number. video length. So we'll go down there. On the CY65, you could choose. Let's see, on this one you can choose, but you are limited to a fixed number. It's 5 minutes, 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds. I'm going to go for 30 seconds. Okay, I don't want 5 minutes or anything, that's enough. Cycle storage, God knows what that means. Should have really read the book. Okay, PIR interval, let's see what that says, 30 seconds, that's as long as mine is, so that's all right. Sensitivity, again, similar to this other one, high, medium, and low, so I've got it on medium. IR brightness, so let's see what that says. Highlight, normal, and economics. Let's go for high. Okay, so we want to have as much detail in these pictures as possible. Okay, so let's go down. Side motion sensors, definitely want those fellas on. We've got them, so let's have them on. There we are, it's on. Let's go down a bit more, see what we've got. Target record time. Okay, let's see, on or off. I'll tell you what, I don't know what that is, but we'll put it on and hopefully that will work. Oh, we don't want that, do we? We don't want that. I don't know what that's doing. So I'll say that's okay. And we want to go off. That looked a bit confusing, that did. Right. Time lapse. Don't want time lapse. Suppose if you want to record something happening all day, you can do that. And but language, time, date, we've set that. Serial number. Don't not interested in that. Temperature, yeah, it'd be nice to do that. So because I'm European, it's in Celsius, not Fahrenheit, but you can do that. Turn the beep sound off. Audio recording, we want that on, so let's see. Yeah, that's on. Okay, and timestamp, yes please. Password protected, yes. As I said, there are horrible people out there who've been around and stolen my cameras in the past. Okay, so password protection, that's on, because I do get some horrible so-and-sos who steal them. What's this? Format memory card, yes please, so we'll do that. It's one thing I would recommend that you do to every card that you do, regardless if it's new or old. There we are, it only takes a second like that. Reset settings, no, we don't want to do that, don't want to know about the version and the mode, so we're back to it. So everything's set on that, so all we've got to do now is click that up to on and she'll be recording. So again, let's turn that one off. It says brilliant. We've got a nice big friendly strap on the side, clip on the side. Yeah, good firm click. The batteries are all in the bottom. This one, unfortunately, doesn't have a tray. You have to drop them in, just like that. Okay, again, 8 batteries. it goes clips over, very positive. Just like on the other one, there is a little thing here where you can plug in an external battery source, but that's just giving people more stuff to rob from me, so I don't bother. Oh, and there's a tripod adapter for, you know, the fixing it to the wall or whatever, which I'd never do. Okay, so now this one, I've never set this up. This is out the box. Okay, so what I'm planning on doing is setting this one up, the base model. Okay, camera, I guess there's the IR sensor. Hasn't got the side sensors like all of the other two. It's only got this forward one. I've never come across the side facing ones before. All of the cameras I've had have been like this, been the cheap ones I could buy off Amazon. So let's open this one up and have a look. There it is. It looks virtually the same as the other one. Okay, bank of LED IRs. Okay, and you've got your battery compartment there at the bottom, but this time it's on the left, not the right. Ooh, that's a difference, I thought. Anyway, okay, and you don't have the little stopper there to protect the DC in or the USB, and I guess that's the microphone there. Hopefully it'll work. That doesn't look that impressive, does it? Anyway, let's get some batteries in here and a SD card. I always use the 32 class 10. I've never had any problems with those, so let's see. Right, so I've put my batteries in. Okay, as you can see, there's a bit of a mismatch of batteries, Duracell and Everready, even though it says in the book, never ever. Mix your batteries, which I've just done. So again, let's just see if that actually makes a difference. So let's cover it up, try not to drop it, doing this all one-handed. Okay, and there it goes. So I guess it shows it can be done if it's all done one-handed. There's my memory cards there. Again, I've got, I'll say, the cheapo ones that you can get from Amazon. Okay, these are about £5 for 4 or 5 of them, instead of like £3 or £4 for the single ones there. So as you can see, it's a 32 gig. Okay, just like all of the others, it goes in the side there. So let's see if we can put that in the side. There we go, it's in the side now. It. So let's turn it on and see what happens. As I said, I haven't turned this one on before. Ooh, there's that annoying beep. And so we've got various languages there: English, French, I guess that's Dutch, Chinese, Cantonese or whatever, Spanish and Italian. So there's the OK button, English. Okay, set the date. Go up. Let's see what that does. 22. Okay. And it is 3:25, so what's wrong with this? 11, 12. Ah, those are the months, aren't they? Yeah. So it's the fourth month. That's me thinking that was the time, dummy. Okay, and it is the third today. Okay, yeah. And now it's the 12-hour clock, and I said it was 15:21 now. 15, okay. Even the birds are complaining about this bloody noise. See what I mean about it? Well, for me, it does get very annoying. Okay. Format memory card, yes. Okay, so that seems to be it. It seems to have sorted everything else out. There's the date, the time, yeah, SD, 62 degrees F. So let's go back into the menu and see if we can change anything. Ah, there we are. That was just the basics. So hopefully you can see that. So we'll go okay for the mode, photo, and we want photo and video, so we'll say okay. Now let's get this so we can see it better. That's it. Now let's go down. Photo resolution, okay. And we want to go to 16 megapixel. Oh, 20, that one goes too. Okay, does it go any higher? No, so let's go back up. 20, that'll do me. Okay, photo series. Yes, please. And we want 3. Yes, please. Video resolution, yes, let's have a look at that. 1080, that's it, it's already selected the highest one. Video length, 10 seconds, 20, 30, so let's go down to 30 again. Okay, cycle storage, I don't know what that means, we'll go on, so I guess that means PI interval, that's okay. Sensitivity, let's see what that's set at. Medium, that's what we want. There's a lot of these things are already set. Target set record time, that's okay. Time lapse, no. Language, we set the language. Time date, we set that. Serial number, temp units, there we go. Fahrenheit or Celsius, Celsius. Let's go back down now, keep going down. Beep sound, let's get that bloody thing off. Can't stand that. Yeah, audio recording on. So it selects virtually all of the main ones itself. There's timestamp, time, date, and logo. Yeah, why not? Let's have the logo on there as well, see what the logo's like. That's if we get anything. Oh God, I hope we do. Password protection, yes. I'll just set that up now, so bear with me. Here we are in the woods. The cameras are all installed, one on top of another, so we can get a fair comparison of their videos and of their still pictures. And that's what they're focused on there, my dear Stan. Just as we left them, let's see, you can got my truck in the background even. They all seem to be okay. Pointing still over towards the deer stand there.
So here we are back at the kitchen table, safely back from the woods. Now, we've got the 65, the 60, and the 55. Quick review of the results. I'll drop those in now.
All we need is a spark, a second chance, a lifeline.
And okay, so my feelings with these cameras, the 65, absolutely outstanding. Out of the pack, that one stands head and shoulders above everything else. Ease of setup, ease of the battery tray, everything I really liked about it. The only downside of it, or the thing I didn't like about it, was that Bluetooth Wi-Fi support. Bit of a gimmick. Yes, it did work. It did work very well. But if you just get yourself one of those downloading card readers that you plug into the bottom of your phone, it does the same thing in the field just as quick, if not quicker. That's the only thing I didn't like about that camera, but the quality of the video, the quality of the pictures, superb. That little camera that's in there, if I can stop moving around too much, that little camera in there is outstanding. The CY60, brilliant. Again, hasn't got that gimmick on it. It's super wide, which is good. 1080, yes. Water protection, yes. Time lapse we didn't use, but going by the quality of photos I got from this, and again that lens in there, it is outstanding. Value for money, I would say it's hard to beat the 65, but if you are on a budget, go for the 60. My only gripe with these cameras was this one, which I'm very disappointed about. As you saw in the, I'm finding this hard to say really, as you saw in the video, they were all put on the tree, one on top of another, so to try and give everybody the same results. This camera didn't give as sharp as everything else. You could make the animal out, you could see a little bit of detail, but it wasn't as sharp as all of the others. Everything else, fine. If we open them up, the clips all working fine, all very good. They held up to various things of wind and rain, so they were all right. Ease of setup, you saw me set this one up, it was perfect. Cards pop in and out perfectly, lovely. I think it was this one which I had the only issue with. Yeah, it is this one. Whoops, it ejects the card, lovely. Is that the card doesn't go in the right way up. You have to put it in upside down. And there it goes. I know it's a little niggle, but didn't like that. But everything else, the clip, waterproof, everything does exactly what it says on the box. This is a superb camera. But this one, even though I didn't like the Wi-Fi on it, me being fussy, I guess, is the winner overall. It is worth every penny, every penny. The CY65, that 30 megapixel camera, yes. I know they all say the 1080, but the 65 and the 60 gave very, very similar results, except this one was pin sharp. You could count the hairs on the deer. Very impressed with this camera. So overall, maybe it's just the one I've got with a funny lens on it, but that one didn't give very clear pictures compared to all of the others. So for me, that's the one I would go for. I would, if I couldn't afford it now, I would save my pennies up, wait a month or two, and buy the 65. Yep, it's got the gimmick on it of the Bluetooth Wi-Fi, but it's still superb. The CY60, if you're like me, worried about things being stolen, definitely the CY60, or even go the 60-55. I know I said it doesn't give me sharp pictures, but if you just want to see what the deer look like, what sort of rack it's got, how many does, how many bucks around, the CY55 will do it. It won't give you the clearest of pictures, unlike the 60 and the 65, who are outstanding quality, but it's okay. It's okay. It's a good budget one. The 60 and the 65 are just outstanding. So Mark Yaler saying bye for now. Thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe. Bye for now.